Hello and welcome. Today we're going to cover how to electronically submit invoices to meet processor requirements using Tabs3 and Taskbill. Taskbill is an add-on product that is used to convert a Tabs3 statement into an electronic bill. It includes over 100 file formats and subformats such as Leeds 1998B, Litigation Advisor, and Legal Guard. Setting up and using a Taskbill format typically consists of the following process: a one-time configuration of the format in Taskbill, configuring any matters that will use that format in Tabs3, entering time and generating a statement in Tabs3, exporting the statement using Taskbill, and uploading your exported file using your processor's preferred method. Let's head over to the knowledge base to look at the quickest way to get started. The amount of configuration required will depend on the format that you're using. From the Help menu, select Internet Resources. Then select Knowledge Base. Next, click the Taskbill link. This article provides specific information that a processor requires and how the software needs to be configured. Notice that under the Selecting a Format section, you have the option to select by organization or by format/subformat. Let's use the format/subformat option and take a look at the Leeds 1998B standard. Once a format is selected, the article dynamically reformats itself to provide specific instructions for creating a file that meets your processor's requirements. Depending on the configuration required, you may need to change settings in Tabs3 Billing, System Configuration, and within Taskbill. Make sure that you have the rights to each of these programs before proceeding. Once the configuration is complete based on the article, you can enter transactions in Tabs3 for billing. If your matter is configured as a task-based billing client, you'll notice that the T code field in the fee and cost windows has been replaced with the phase, task, and activity or expense ID fields. The phase/task code designates the phase of the case in which the work was performed. For this example, you're communicating with an expert witness regarding this matter, so we'll select L130 expert/consultants. The activity or expense ID code corresponds to the transaction code you would normally use and indicates the type of work performed. You would select A108, Communicate, Other External for this example, which on the task code lookup you can see uses our normal T-code 13 to determine rates and other billing options. If special phase/task activity or expense ID codes are needed, you can add them using the task code tab of the miscellaneous data entry window. Note that not all e-bills require the use of these codes. Everything else about the fee and cost entry process remains the same. For more information about entering fees and costs, check out the Working with Fees and Working with Costs training videos. Once all of your transactions have been entered for this billing cycle, you'll need to generate and update your statements using the normal billing process. Now you're ready to export your statements. Let's open Taskbill from the Quick Launch application bar. Then, from the File menu, select Export. After you select the required Taskbill format, specify the client or range of clients to export e-bills for and the statement date. If your processor requires a special subformat or timekeeper format, select those options now. By default, the selected range of clients will export as one file, but you can choose to export as separate files for each client. When ready, click OK. From here, you can specify where you want the file to be saved and rename the file if needed. You're now ready to upload this file to your e-billing processor. And that's it. For more information about Taskbill, check out our help topics by clicking on the question mark icon or by pressing F1 on your keyboard. Thanks for watching. See you next time.